pretty day out here, huh? 14 degrees. Hey, greetings from the Northwoods of Wisconsin. I'm the Northwoods of Wisconsin guy, Dan, KD9MSP. We're going to have another little discussion here about a little antenna deployment system that I kind of rigged up to make things easier. You don't need as many components, and we'll talk about that in a little bit. Brought Ginger with me. She can't let me come outside here without bringing her with me. She's just got to be here with me. Such a loving little pal. You going to go run? So I talked about this a little bit on the Facebook page here, but what we got going on, there's so many different things for deploying. You got your basic tripod. Everybody can get one of those. This happens to be a Monfrato type tripod that I had for photography when I was doing a lot of that. And what I did is I attached a piece of fibrous, it's a fiber piece of Unistrut. Stick around to the end of the video. I'm going to talk about Unistrut more if you haven't heard of it. If you're an electrician, I know you've heard of it. So we've got the Unistrut going on there, which is a highly versatile system for attaching things. Above that is a piece of 7/8 stainless Unistrut. Both Unistruts are slotted. We'll talk about those later too. But I got different options going on here. This is Chameleon's coil that they've got here. And all I have mounted on top of that, and I'll show you close-ups of this in a little bit, is a 3/8 by 24 rod nut. It's just simply for screwing this on. From that point, once that's on, everything's connected with the 7/8 stainless Unistrut to a puck in the middle here for ground radials. 4mm ground radials, plug them in, do whatever you want to do with ground radials. It's all done, you're ready to go. Put whatever antenna you want on there, 17-foot or 25-foot stainless. On this end right over here, we've got a 25-foot stainless, the SS25 from Chameleon, and also, and I hate to say it, it's a CB mount. Antenna mount that's below here. What that enables you to do is just hook your coax right to that antenna. And you're good to go with that. Once again, the radials are in place. You can do different combinations or whatever variations you want to do with radials. On the bottom down here, I'm going to have to get the camera and show you things a little bit closer up here, what we got going on. But depending on what antenna you want to have on here, it's also rigged to go. In this case, because we've got the SO239 connector down here, you can put on your Wolf River coil. Put your antenna on top of that and go. If you don't want Chameleon's transformer on here, it's a 5-to-1. Let's switch over to a Recon 40 from Res Antenna Systems. This is a beautiful fist system that you can just put a 17-foot whip on it, switch with a switch on it here. If you want to go and completely bypass the coil just for the 17-foot whip, hook your coax right in here on the SO239. You've also got your radio system already deployed. It's ready to go. Put whatever whip on top of that you want. You can go 20 meters and just switch it, and automatically you've got a 40 meter coil that's on here. Or if you want to use another product of Res's, is the Ranger 80. Ranger 80 also has a puck on the bottom, comes with it. But actually, you don't need the puck. You're already hooked up with this puck for your radio system. It's all set to go. Coax to here, antenna to here, and you're off and set, ready to deploy. So I'll just take this off. I wanted to talk about the Unistrut system a little bit. Unistrut's used in construction quite a bit for electricians, plumbers. If Joe was watching this, I know he's going to know when I talk about it. If you're an electrician, you know exactly what I'm talking about. I'm going to grab the camera here and we'll take a look at things a little bit closer up with what Unistrut is all about. So back to close-ups here with the unistrut system. You can see it's slotted. So there's holes pre-drilled. You can get it non-slotted also. And I just simply attached that to the bottom of the tripod in this area right over here. I attached it kind of permanently, but that's what I came up with at the time. And I've got things bolted through. And what you see underneath there, I hope this shows up on film, it's called a spring nut or a strut nut. I'll show you these a little bit more close up too here. This is what unistrut looks like. It's about 1 5/8 by 1 5/8. This one happens to be, well, like I say, 1 5/8 deep, but they do make it 7/8, which is what the one on the top of here is 7/8 inch. It's only 7/8 inch thick this way, 1 5/8 inch that way. Then on top, I talked about the strut nuts. This is what a spring nut looks like. It's got a spring. It's got, this happens to be a 1/4-20, but they make them in 3/8 also. The spring nut springs right into here and just hooks right into the unistrut for attaching different things. I'll show you a close up of that a little bit here. You can slide it anywhere you want to. Very, very versatile system. And then to isolate things, we see a lot of blanking stubs that are coming out now for separating your radials from this tripod. Getting, you don't want any signal coming through that and messing up your radials. So I've got a piece of fibrous strut in here. Show what that looks like. That's also 1 5/8 slotted because it's got slots in it. And that's going to isolate the whole system from everything else there. Then, along the same lines here, so I've got the camera off the tripod. Now let's take a look at what's coming down along the tripod here. We've got the makings of a POTA dominator. I have not tried this out yet. I've tried it in different configurations, but once again, if you were to lower this down, we're able to hook that up to one of these connections on here. Below, we're going to have radios coming off of here. Some of them are going to be tuned radios. We got a choke that's going on here to hook your coax up to. And that's going to be a system that I might have to talk about someday. But there's a lot of different things. If you like the Robocov antenna or the POTA dominator, you'll find a lot of stuff on that concerning the system. And it's a really great system. But stick around. Gonna have another video coming up, and I hope I helped you out with some of the ideas here. I just wanted to make it simple, something that works easy rather than to keep buying blanks and different adapters and everything else.